Good morning, dear students. Today we are starting a new topic, which is a disorder commonly seen in children in neuropathology. The topic is autism spectrum disorders. So definition, the autism spectrum means we are not talking about a particular single condition. It is a spectrum of disorders. Many disorders are combined together and called as a which is commonly called as ASD, that is autism spectrum disorder. Describes a range of conditions classified as neurodevelopmental disorders in the fifth revision of the American Psychiatric Association's Diagnostic and Statistical Manual of Mental Disorder, fifth edition. So we commonly call this definition is under the classification of the neurodevelopmental disorders under DSM-5, that is the fifth edition, DSM-5, and the DSM-5 published in the 2013 redefined the autism spectrum disorder, which was given in the fourth DSM of diagnosis of autism. Before going to the characteristics of the definition, it is actually the definition of the DSM-5 which you are following, which also includes the Asperger's syndrome, pervasive developmental disorder, and childhood disintegrative disorder. So what are the characteristics of ASD? These disorders, along with the above mentioned disorders, are characterized by social deficits, communication difficulties, stereotyped or repetitive behaviors, repetitive behaviors and repetitive interest, that's what they mean, sensory issues, and in some cases cognitive delays. So all these characteristics should be present, and according to the variations we can classify those into different disorders. So the characteristics of autism spectrum disorders are characterized by social deficits, communication difficulties, stereotype or repetitive behaviors or repetitive interests, in sensory issues, and in some cases even cognitive delays. Okay, now we'll go to the classification. The new diagnosis encompasses previous diagnosis of autistic disorder, Asperger's disorder, childhood disintegrative disorder, and PDD, which is full form is pervasive developmental disorder, which we have mentioned earlier. So all these disorders encompasses, and according to that we will have to see each differently. Rather than categorizing these diagnoses, the DSM-5 will adopt a dimensional approach to diagnosing the disorders that fall underneath the autism spectrum umbrella. So here we are, the new DSM-5, that is a statistical manual for diagnosis in mental disorders, they try to see all these condition under a common umbrella term called as autism spectrum. That is where we use the word autism spectrum umbrella or autism spectrum disorder. It is thought that individuals with ASDs are best represented as a single diagnostic category because they demonstrate similar types of symptoms and are better differentiated by clinical specifiers, that is dimensions of the severity. The clinical specifiers means like the criteria under which basically the criteria are classified under the dimensions of severity and associated features. So basically two things will define the classification. One is the dimension of severity. Second is associated features. So what are the associated features? That is non-genetic disorders, epilepsy, intellectual disability. So these four things basically. One thing is totally the severity of the problem. Second is associated features, which are three: genetic disorders, epilepsy, intellectual disability. So severity of the social deficit, repetitive behavior, all those things earlier mentioned is one factor which is a prerequisite for classification. Then the other three are genetic disorders, epilepsy, and intellectual disability. In an additional change to the DSM, that is the Diagnostic Statistical Manual of Mental Disorders, DSM short form, includes collapsing social and communication deficits into one domain. So social and communication deficit, because if there is communication deficit, it will lead to social problem. If a child has a social difficulty, social understanding, comprehending social relationships, and in a what you call avoidance of social conversations or communications, then it will lead to communication speech deficit also, both the comprehension and the motor part of the speech. Thus, an individual with an AST diagnosis will be described in terms of severity of social communication symptoms. So severity of the social communication symptoms, severity of fixed behavior, or what we call as a repetitive behavior, fixation, or sometimes even repetitions of the behavior, both motor as well as motor behavior as well as the sensory interests, restricted behaviors or interests and associated features. The restriction of onset age has also been loosened from 3 years of age to early development. Earlier on, before the DSM-5, earlier on, they used to think about at least to give the children 3 years time to say that, okay, this child has autistic. Nowadays, we are not waiting till 3 years of age. We are even going into the early developmental period with a note that symptoms may manifest later when demands exceed capabilities. So, though we don't wait till the age of 3, so that we'll see, note the symptoms manifest, that whatever we are expecting, the sensory and the motor milestone or any other functional skills from a child with 3 years age, when it is lacking, we will think about the what is wrong with the child. So we don't, nowadays we go try to do that early developmental period itself. There are a lot of screening methods and interviews and methods to screen and to identify children's having risk factors for ASD. Autism forms the core of autism spectrum disorders. Asperger's syndrome is closest to autism in signs and likely causes. Unlike autism, people with Asperger's syndrome have no significant delay in language development. The common example I give is a character played by Shah Rukh Khan in the movie My Name is Khan. He has Asperger's syndrome. So he has good intellectual capacity. He has a good language this thing, but he does not have eye contact. He lacks social. He tries to be away from people. He is not normal in social. Otherwise, he's a very so this condition, Asperger's syndrome, has no significant delay in language development. Pervasive development disorder, significant. This NOS means not very significant, sense cannot be diagnosed perfectly. So is diagnosed when the criteria are not met for a more specific disorder. So PDD, commonly we say we don't get a diagnosis, then we put the child into PDD. Some sources also include Rett syndrome and childhood disintegrative disorder, which share several signs with autism but may have unrelated causes, but group all of the above conditions into the pervasive developmental disorders. So what is a developmental course? Normally we have a developmental course for children. So how do these children with fall inside this spectrum disorder, autism spectrum disorder, what is their course of development or total development? Although autism spectrum disorders are thought to follow two possible developmental courses, most parents report that symptom onset occurred within the first year of life. So it can start from the first year of the life itself. One course of development follows a gradual course of onset in which parents report concerns in development over the first 2 years of life, and diagnosis is made around 3 to 4 years of age. Some of the early signs of ASDs in this course include decreased looking at faces. That is what we call as no eye contact. The child will not have face contact will not be there. The child will not look into the face. Failure to turn when the name is called. If you call the child by his or her name, the child will not turn to you. Normally the child will look at the person who is calling their name. Failure to show interest by showing or pointing. And delayed pretended play. Just imagine, these are the signs which, if you see any child of the age of 3, between the age of 3 to 4, you call the child's name, the child should look at you. When the child looks at you and when you continue talking, the child should look at your eye. That means you are face to face. If this too does not happen, then you can suspect the child may be having some problem related to AST. Again, if you want to see, failure to show, the child will not usually will communicate to you, even though the child is not a good talker, maybe not a good talker, or not in a good verbal communication, still the child should be able to point you and show you this thing, that thing which is interested. And he should pretend to play with you, try to hide and seek, like this, those kind of activities should happen. If these things are lacking, you can suspect that the child have some kind of a problem, which maybe don't go into a diagnosis suddenly. You can say that, sir, I suspect the child may be belonging to autism spectrum disorder. A second course of development is characterized by normal or near normal development followed by loss of skills or regression in the first 2-3 years. Regression means coming back. Whatever the child have gained, suddenly the child losing all those learned skills. That is what we call as loss of skills. Maybe the child was singing a rhyme, suddenly the child cannot sing that rhyme. The child was able to talk few words to the mother, now the child is not using that word. So those kind of things are called as regression, which includes in a variety of domains, including communication, social, cognitive, self-help skills. So these are the areas where the regression may happen: communication, social skills, cognitive skills, and self-help skills. However, the most common regression is loss of language. So usually the sign of regression is the mother will start worrying, saying that my child was communicating with me, saying a few words, now suddenly the child is not using that word, not singing a particular poem or rhyme. So these kind of complaints may come from the mother or parents. There continues to be a debate over the differential outcomes based on these two developmental courses. Some studies suggest that regression is associated with poorer outcomes, and others report no differences between those with early gradual onset and those with who experience a regression period. So even though I told you this, the study itself are contradicting. Many studies are against other studies, so they don't give you 100% effectiveness. So overall, the prognosis is poor for persons with classical autism, which is otherwise called as Carnot type, which is actually named after a doctor who worked in John Hopkins Hospital in the 1932. He only classified this classical autism condition. So with respect to the academic achievement, and poor to below average for persons across the autism spectrum with respect to independent living abilities in each case. A lack of early intervention exacerbates the odds against success. Mean that if you delay the proper intervention, in which intervention physiotherapy also is a part, so if you are delaying the intervention, the chance of success is less.